Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be talking you through a few purchases that I've made from Zara, and some of them I've tried on, some of them I haven't. So we're going to see how I feel about them together and see which things I want to keep, which things I want to send back. You guys know the deal. I actually picked up these things a few weeks back. Hopefully things are still in stock, but I've been waiting to go through most of it with you, and I realized that we're very quickly coming up to the Christmas period, so I wanted to talk you through this before we get into like Christmas vlogs and all that lovely stuff. There is also a really lovely winter coat in this video, which might be my favorite winter coat of 2020, and I wanted to show that to you before winter is like kind of irrelevant. And I'll pop everything that I plan on keeping and sending back in the info box below, along with sizing. But as always, I would love your opinion on what you love and don't love, so do let me know what things you think I should keep and return in the comments below. But without any more chat, let's get on with the video, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Okay, we have got the big box, people. It was heavy. Can we all just take a moment for the thumbnail where I was basically holding the whole weight of the box with one hand? My wrist hurts. So firstly, lots of you will be pleased to hear that I actually picked up a new pair of, these are like the waxed coated leggings, I believe, from Zara. I picked these up in a size small, and basically I picked these up because I have a lot of like leather style leggings from Zara and I love them, but I have been moaning a lot recently that lots of them are just too big and gapey on me. So I decided to pick up a new pair in a smaller size, and I'm very happy with these. These are lovely. They don't have too much of a sheen to them, which I really like, because my other leather leggings from Zara are very, very like sheeny leather looking, and it's lovely, but sometimes I just think that I want something a little bit more pared back. So these are a really lovely pair, and I really like the seam that they have running down the front. It makes them look kind of smart. I think this pair might come in like a cream color as well, for anyone that is interested, but for me, I'm just not a fan of kind of like lighter trousers until we get into summer, and I think these would be a little bit too warm for the summer months. So these are the Waxed Effect leather leggings on. I'm really happy with them. They fit like a dream, which I am so happy about, because if you've watched the videos for long enough, you'll know how much I've been moaning about my other leather leggings from Zara, that they just don't fit anymore. I'm not sure if they just loosen up over time, because I remember I used to have to fight to get them on, but it's so nice to have a pair that fit really snug. They look great. I'm so happy with them. I feel like they were quite inexpensive, even by Zara standards as well, so would definitely recommend. I'm very happy with them. They are a little bit longer on the leg, as you can see, but I can roll them up. Also, if I'm wearing boots that come up a little bit higher on the ankle, it just covers it up completely, so it's not something that I'm too worried about. But if I am wearing like trainers or something like that, I will just roll them under, and it's not that much of a big deal. So very, very happy with these. Next up, let's take a moment for some knitwear, shall we? I picked up this long kind of knitted, almost like a coatigan. It feels quite thick and like heavy. I picked this up in a size small. It's very, very similar actually to my Mango coatigan, which I love so much. I have it in a tan, but this is in a really gorgeous, just like creamy white, and I thought this would be lovely for wearing around the house and just in general. Really, this will do me for like both at home when I'm just wearing like trackies and a top, and if I'm like popping to my mum's house, this would be a really lovely option. I think it is very long, so we'll see where it comes to on me. For reference, because I know a lot of people that don't subscribe to my channel have watched these videos, I'm 5'2", so bear that in mind when I do the try-ons. But yeah, this looked so lovely, and I really feel like you can dress it up or dress it down, so I'm very, very excited to try this one on. Okay, so this look I am obsessed with. I love this cardigan. It feels so soft. The length of it is like just right for me. It's not too long, so I can definitely get away with like wearing it out of the house, like popping to the shops in it. It looks like it could be a coat, but it's like a cardigan. It's one of those like dream items for me to have in my wardrobe. Honestly, it feels amazing. It feels heavy enough to keep me warm, but lightweight enough that it doesn't feel too much for being indoors, and like I said, it's just so soft, so there's nothing like irritating me. It's not that kind of knit that feels scratchy at all. I am obsessed. It's softer than my Mango coatigan, which is just amazing, because I love that coat cardigan hybrid so much, but it's just like, it's not soft enough to wear as like a cardigan indoors, but this is, it feels amazing. And it has pockets. This is just the dream. If you liked my Mango coatigan but you didn't like the color, you might want to look at this. This is just an actual dream. I'm so happy with it. I've paired it with this body, which is also from Zara, which isn't in the main part of the haul, but if you made it this far, then you have a sneaky little bonus item. It literally arrived the other day. I saw it on the website and I was like, yeah, I need that. I love it. I love the color of it. so much. It's almost like the same color as the body, the long sleeve knitted jumper body that you saw earlier in the video. It works so beautifully with this cardigan, and I've paired it with the waxed leather effect leggings, and I rolled them up so you can see what they kind of look like when I do roll them up, and I think they look great. They roll up really nicely as well. And then I've just got my Vajra trainers on with it, but this is a look that I love. I'm so happy with this. But yeah, I think these two are like the star of the show for this haul. I think I'm probably gonna say that about a few items. You guys know I love a winter white. Following that, I picked up this lovely stretchy little ribbed knit. This might actually be a bit cropped, you know. I'm intrigued. I'm very intrigued. That you can't really tell when you hold it up. It's very bat wingy. I'm really intrigued by this. Very excited to try it on. It's got like very tight cuffs that are quite long. This could be great. It could be really weird. We'll see. So the ribbed slouchiness, I love. This feels so nice. Like it's actually like feels kind of heavy, and I love that. I really like the way it falls. I like the way it sits around my collarbones. You could have it kind of like off shoulder and slouchy if you wanted, or you can just have it like straight up kind of like in the middle. I love the fact that the sleeves are tighter. It kind of gives you this like balloon bat wing sleeve effect. I don't know, I just think it's really cool, and I love how floaty it is. I think this is a really good option for this time of year, you know, if you're going for like country roast in a pub, or just, you know, your regular roast dinners at home, any kind of eating kind of social occasion, however small or minimal, I think this would be a great one because it's really nice and loose over your stomach. I think it's very flattering. I think this would be really flattering on a lot of different body shapes. Really, really gorgeous. And obviously it comes in the black if you have a real aversion to white. Yeah, it feels so lovely. Really nice and soft, really weighty, like a good quality piece of knitwear. No, it's not cashmere, it's not fancy, but it feels really lovely to wear. Very, very soft, very inoffensive, and I love the silhouette. I also picked up like a high neck fitted rib corset top style thing, kind of similar to what I'm wearing now, but a little bit longer. This is actually like cropped, and it had almost like a seam under the boob, and I love it. It's actually in the wash, so I will just put a picture here and then swipe to a cutaway of me trying it on. It is so lovely, and I've been getting a lot of wear out of it recently. You might have already seen it in a vlog, so I'll kind of like spare you if you've already seen it. So this is the cream ribbed kind of like corset effect high neck top that I was telling you about. I have been getting a surprising amount of wear out of this lately. When I first ordered it, I was like, I might not get so much wear out of that. I'm just not sure that I'm gonna love this kind of shape around the boobs. My boobs aren't normally an area of my body that I like to kind of highlight in this way, so I really wasn't sure on how much wear I would get out of this. But what I have been doing, just because the first time I tried this on, I tried it on without a bra, and my boobs were like way below this lining, what I've been doing is actually wearing like a bandeau bra that I have that is nude, and it's definitely not a loungewear bandeau bra. It kind of like really holds you in, so it works quite well. The bra is from Skims, which I think they've just launched on Selfridges if you're in the UK. But yeah, it's definitely been very handy at actually allowing me to wear a top like this. It's definitely with my boobs and the size that they are, it's not something that I'd normally be able to wear. So that was definitely a game-changing discovery for me. So like I said, I've been getting a lot of wear out of it. I've been really happy with it. The only thing I would say is I normally like to put this on before I put makeup on. I don't know if I've managed to get makeup on the roll neck just now, but it is a very, very tight and non-stretchy neck fit. So because my hair was up and I'd done my makeup, I was really trying to get it to like stretch over without like touching or ruining either one, and I did not succeed. So if that is like a pet peeve for you like it is for me, definitely bear that in mind. I just have to make sure that I like put this on before I do my hair and makeup. But yeah, other than that, it's very cute. Looks really nice with any kind of trousers, really. You could wear it with more tailored trousers if that is your kind of preference. Leather leggings. I wore this yesterday just with a pair of black skinny jeans and my like high lace up Zara boots. It's a very versatile little kind of like thin knit, and I'm getting on very well with it. I'm definitely enjoying it having this little detail. It just makes it a little bit more interesting than wearing one of my plain kind of like high neck jumpers. I also picked up this knitted bodysuit. I don't have anything like this. I don't have anything in this color either, and I really don't know how this is gonna go down when I try it on, but I'm so intrigued by it, and it feels so soft and so cozy. I got this in a size small. It's £30. It's got like bat winged sleeves, and it's just this gorgeous like dusky brownie kind of tone, so I'm very excited to try that on. It's got very wide sleeves. This could be amazing, or it could just be really weird. I feel like there's a running theme of the knits in this video. They could be amazing, but they could also be really weird. So I'll try it on, I'll show you, as with everything else, I'll show you how I'll style it up. We'll see. So this is the knitted body. I am so happy with this. It looks so cute. I love it. I absolutely love it. It does give you a little bit of, I was about to say LVP. VPL. It does give you a little bit. I have kind of like quaked the seams in a little bit just so it's not so bad. And I did make sure when I was putting it on that I pulled the seam kind of up over my hip as well, because that's just something I tend to do with all of my bodies. If they aren't a thong cut, I do tend to pull them a little bit higher, because then you just don't get the VPL kind of here all right across your bum, so it's a lot more flattering. It fits really nicely. I know bodies aren't always super practical for everyone, and some people would just prefer to wear like a standard jumper, and I totally get that, because when you gotta pee, you gotta pee, you know. But I actually do really like it, because it means that you don't actually have to tuck your jumper. You don't get any of the kind of like bulkiness here when you tuck a jumper, because it's just like, I don't know, it's so cool. I think it's really clever. So it's literally ribbed and quite like supportive, not like super like tight or anything, but just like structured because of the rib effect that it has lower down, and it stops about here and then it just slouches over, and it looks like the perfect, literally the perfect knitwear tuck. I just love it. I love the color as well. I think it's the most gorgeous color. It looks really nice, I think, on my skin tone with my hair color. So very, very happy with it. And I love like the bat wingy kind of sleeve. So yeah, this I wasn't sure on, but it's actually, I think it's one of the stars of this order for me. I was obviously really feeling the like 90s vibes with this order. I picked up some like stirrup leggings. These remind me of my mum in my very early childhood. I don't know why. Did she own them? Did she even own them? I'm questioning that now. Must have. I watched some home vlogs back, like home vlogs, like my mum is walking around with this huge camera on her shoulder. I watched some home vlog footage back a few weeks back, and she was like typical 90s girl. I loved it. But yeah, I am excited to try these on. I love a 90s vibe. So this with like an oversized sweatshirt, I think would look amazing. But equally with like a smarter knit on top, this could also be really lovely. I picked these up in a size small, and just on first look, my only reservation is that the legging material isn't particularly firm. It might just be that I'm used to like activewear leggings where they're quite thick and very tight. We'll see how this goes, but it might be a little bit too like thin and flimsy in terms of the material for me. Okay, so the stirrup leggings, is that what we're calling them? I don't even know. These leggings probably aren't for me. I am just not sure about how I feel about the extra material like on the bottom of my foot. Part of me thinks it's cool, and then part of me just thinks this is way too much of a faff. And I don't know, I'm kind of irritated by the little bit of extra material. I would love to know what you think about these. I'm just not really sure that I truly understand the point. I think they could look cool if you wore them with like, I don't know, maybe like a court shoe, like a really high-heeled like court shoe with trainers. Like, do they look that different? Is it really worth purchasing and swapping out your usual leggings for these? I don't think so. However, if you are very invested in this trend and you want to make a purchase, they are a very nice pair of leggings. I like the sheen on them. They're very opaque. They're not, like I said in the main bit, they're not too thick, so they're not going to do much at all for holding you in. This band here, very thick, but actually everything below that isn't. I kind of wish with Zara leggings they would, and they never do this, they never panel the whole thing. They always do like a tight bit of elastic around the waist, which cinches in your waist, which is great, but the rest of your stomach just wants to bulge out underneath, so it just doesn't actually look as cute as I think they're trying to make it. They feel really nice. However, I do think this time of year they are probably a bit too thin for my personal taste. I do think I would feel a bit chilly in these. We then have a little two set, and I have seen possibly every single human that I know that shops on Zara taking the piss out of this. And it is understandable as to why, because they literally call these like arm warmers, and everyone is like, is that a thing? That is so stupid. But I see what Zara are doing here. And it is kind of a scam. They've basically taken what should be one top and chopped it into two, and they're selling it in separate parts. So this would look lovely. Like, just imagine if this is one piece, because I really actually do like this. But I think the fact that it's not sold, like they're either not joined or sold as a set together, is a bit of a ripoff. But I wanted to try this on and see if it was cute, because if not, then I'll join everyone else in taking the mick out of it. But if it's cute, I'll wear it. So you have your strapless top, and then you have your little kind of like cardigan bit which goes over your arms, and together it could look really cute, but separately both kind of stupid, but I quite like that about it and I wanted to give it a go because you know me, I'll try anything on Zara. Well, not technically anything. I have done a video on stuff that I would not buy from Zara, which I will link if you want to go and watch it, just for a laugh. I wasn't being like super serious in it. I think some people took it way too seriously. But anyway, I'll show you what those all look like on. So the top and arm warmer combo, I am just not sold on, which is sad because I originally thought it could be quite cool, but there are a few adjustments that if this was like my product that I would have made to this. Number one, the arm warmers kind of just like slip off as you're wearing them, like they don't want to stay on your shoulders, as you can see. And unless I'm missing that there is some way to kind of clip them, it's going to be very, very annoying. And because it's a piece of knitwear, knitwear likes to slouch and knitwear likes to become more loose over time, so it's only going to get more annoying even if you size down. I believe I got a small. Oh, let me check that. Yeah, size small, but I like the fact that the arms are tight. It's just the top part that's letting it down. I think if it was tighter, yes, it could run the potential of being like slightly restrictive, but like I said, it's knitwear and knitwear likes to loosen up. Also, these, like, why do these exist, honestly? So yeah, it would have been nice if even if there was like an option to kind of like attach the two, and with the actual like base of the top, I would have loved if this could have been a body or just had some kind of like optional strap if you didn't want to buy the arm warmers and you just wanted to wear it like as a single, or you bought the arm warmers but you just want to take the arm warmers off and like have a top that doesn't slip down. This is because it's knitwear, like I said, it likes to be soft and slouchy. It does want to slouch down. If I don't tuck it into trousers, it also wants to ride up as well, which just kind of leaves you with a lot of like rippled material around here, which I just like that, but like extreme. I just don't think it's great. I think if anything, there should at least have been a little bit of like an elastic kind of like material on the inside here just to really keep it here. And there definitely should have been the same along the seam of the arm warmers as well, because that would have kind of helped to keep everything in place really nicely. Because ultimately, this could have been a really nice cut. If you can keep it like this, it's very cute, but it's just not gonna stay that way. It's not practical. I also wish it was less kind of like baggy here, but I guess it just looks like a cute cardigan that's like nice and cropped from the back. But yeah, it's just not a winner for me. I don't think it's practical. If it was like perfect, worked really, really beautifully, was very flattering and stayed in place, I would be like, yeah, you know, it's a bit of a scam paying for like two parts that make up one top. But you know, it does look really, really cute and yeah, definitely spend your money on it. But it's an annoyance and you're paying basically double the price for it, which I don't think is ideal. I would love to know your thoughts. I think I know what those thoughts are gonna be. I feel like we know each other well enough here for me to know that the majority of you will probably agree with me that it's an absolute waste of money. But yeah, do let me know. And then we have the black version of the white ribbed knit. You know me, if my spidey senses are telling me that something might be cute, I will buy it in both colors, especially if one of those colors is black, because yeah. So I'll show you what this one looks like too, and for reference I got both in a size medium. I actually think this could work and be cuter than the white one. I think I'm more likely to wear a black knit with leggings and more casual pieces, so I think this is probably the one that I might get more wear out of if they're cute. You'll know better than me by now because I will have already tried on the white one. But anyway, I'll show you what that one looks like on now. And this is the black ribbed knit. I just love these. I think they look so cute. I love the cut of them. I think they're meant to be cropped, but obviously on me they're just a little bit longer, but I really like the way they fall. They feel so nice. I will have already talked you through this with the white one, but yeah, they both get a thumbs up from me. I think they're a really great wardrobe basic for this time of year. Next up is this gorgeous autumnal jacket. My reservation on this is that we are so quickly moving out of like autumnal territory and just racing towards winter right now. Like day by day it gets more and more wintry around here, so I'm a bit scared that this one might have like had its moment, so I might send this one back. But I wanted to show it to you guys anyway because it's just such a gorgeous tone, and I think for a lot of people, if you like a like belted jacket, this would be a staple in your wardrobe. It's this gorgeous like red faux leather tie waist jacket, and it is absolutely stunning. I think they need to re-release this piece, just not in 2020, because I just don't feel like it was the year for this jacket. I'm very tempted to keep it for next autumn because I think it would come into a league of its own when I can actually like really dress it up. I would love to know your thoughts on this. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Do you think it's had its moment, or would you still wear this throughout winter? Let me know. I know we're coming into like real winter territory now, and there will be a lot of you that are from like northern parts that are very much in need of like heavier coats, but there are still a lot of people that can get away with kind of like lighter jackets in the winter. So with that in mind, would love to know your thoughts on it. So this is our little burgundy jacket, which I just think is gorgeous. This is how I kind of envisioned styling it up when I first purchased it. So I've got the waxed effect leather look leggings on with a pair of boots that I got from ASOS, I think a year ago now. I think they've brought them back. If they have, I will link them or I'll try and find you similar. But these are just such a dreamy pair of boots. I really like them. And you guys know I love croc. I love a croc texture, and I thought that that would add really beautifully to this jacket. Do let me know whether you think I should keep it or return it. Will I wear it again next autumn? That needs to be a serious consideration for me. I do think it's such a beautiful, very timeless piece that I would probably keep for a really long time. So I'm kind of swaying towards keeping it, but do let me know your thoughts. I want to know. I love the fact that it has pockets as well. Oh no, wait, these ain't real. That's sad. Okay, minus points for the fact that these pockets are not real, because that would be goals. It's coming off as a lot more of like a reddy, chocolatey, kind of like burnt red tone on camera, which is kind of weird. To me, looking in the mirror, it definitely has like a purple tone to it, but that's not really translating on camera, but it is so beautiful. And then my final piece of knitwear before I move on to one of my favorite pieces in this video is this cropped knit. I know not everyone's a fan of a crop, but I really love this. There's something about it that I just absolutely fell in love with, and I'm not really one for grey, and I'm definitely not really one for like a chunky knit like this. I am not the biggest fan. I was very scared that this was going to be incredibly itchy. It's actually not, which I'm pleasantly surprised by. I got this in a size small, and it is very cropped, so I would say if you don't want it so cropped, definitely size up. It is very, very cropped, as you can see that front hem, like it really comes up at the front. So really I would only wear it with very, very like high-waisted items. I think it actually looks lovely with the knitted wide leg trousers I'm currently wearing at the moment. I wear these a lot when I work from home. I absolutely love them. I wear them a lot with like cropped high necks, as I'm wearing today. But this also could look really nice with like some leather high-waisted trousers. Next we have the grey jumper. If I hadn't ruined my makeup before, then I definitely have now, trying to get this one on. It's not the tightest neck, but it's, you know, just tight enough that if you're already wearing makeup, it's going to be a bit of a pain to get over your head. It is a very cute knit, but I do think this is going to divide a lot of opinions. Those of you that don't love a crop will either want to steer clear of this altogether or definitely size up. I got my regular size and it is very, very cropped. So I would say definitely size up one size if you're unsure. I'm wearing a small and it is just like that little bit, tiny, tiny bit more cropped than I would have liked. So yeah, definitely something to wear in mind. You could wear it back to front, but I don't love the way it's cut in that sense. When wearing back to front, the neckline sits a little bit differently and I don't love it. It makes it feel a lot more like high up. And I do prefer when you get a little bit of neck with any high neck, because I just think it elongates you. It doesn't make you look like a floating head. Like, I hate a roll neck that makes me look like this. So I prefer the way the neck falls this way around versus back to front. So yeah, it is very cropped. I'm also wearing like very high-waisted leather leggings. So yeah, bear that in mind if you are interested in purchasing this one. It is very, very cropped. I would love to know, do you like this? Would you steer clear? Let me know in the comments. And then finally, we have what is probably my favorite coat that I've picked up this year. The only thing I would say about this is the color is actually a slightly warmer tone in real life than it looked on the website. I was kind of expecting this to be a little bit more of a cool toned gray, like almost ever so slightly sagey, and it's not. It's definitely like a very warm toned gray, which I don't normally love, but in this coat, I really, really love that tone. It's also very unique. It's not something that I've seen a lot before or have in my wardrobe, and I really like that about it. I believe this said on one of the tags, which I've now removed because I am like full on like dedicated to keeping this, I believe it was like a water repellent jacket, and let me tell you, it is so warm. It's so incredibly warm. I absolutely love it. I love all of the black detailing on it as well. I think that's quite rare with a coat. Like, I've never seen a coat in this color, but it's also like quite rare with these jackets in general. I don't tend to see like black faux fur, and then it's also got a black belt with a black buckle as well, and I really love that detailing to it. It's also got nice big pockets. It's got like the elasticated cuff sleeves, so this really does keep you so warm. I love this, and it fits like a dream as well. What size did I get this in? I got this in a size small, and it also has this black faux fur lining, but only like around the top, so it's not like too much and too bulky underneath around the rest of the body. But I absolutely love this. I will show you my favorite way of styling it in the cutaways. There's a particular bag that I like wearing with it as well. It just all works together really nicely. But this is definitely my favorite coat purchase of the year. Last year was definitely my All Saints E-Crew like puffer jacket. That was an absolute gem and I still love it and wear it so much now, but it's lovely to have something that has a hood and that I know it's water repellent so that I can like go on my winter walks and just know that I'm not gonna get absolutely drenched. And it's also just so cute as well. So yeah, I will show you what that looks like on, but this is the absolute dream and I'm so happy with it. Okay, so next we have coat of my mum's dreams and she'll die watching this because I'm obviously wearing a crop top underneath it.
You can give a girl a practical coat, but definitely doesn't mean she's got two brain cells to rub together, you know?
So we've got the zip on the inside and then we've got little popper buttons as well.
I love the thick black belt. I like that it cinches the waist in.
It's practical, but it's pulled together at the same time and I'm just obsessed with it. And I love the gray tone. It's so beautiful. The hood is huge. The hood is huge and it buttons up all the way to the top as well. So I walked the other day with my dad and he was literally like, you look like an Eskimo, but I'm a warm Eskimo, so I'll take it.
I've paired it with my Waxed Effect leather leggings that are from this haul as well, and then my ASOS boots. I do think that having like a statement boot with this, it does take it from dog walk to something you could wear like socially or even like professionally depending on what you do for work. So yeah, I just love it. I think it's very versatile. It looks cute with my leggings and my trainers and my walking boots and my wellies, but it also looks cute with like everything else in my wardrobe as well. So I really love it and I think it's a great purchase for me considering the amount of walks I am going on and have already been on this year. My life has changed so much. Anyway, cute coat.
I'll show you the bag I like to wear with it as well. This bag I love wearing with it. It's got a lovely brown tone to it, but it's also got the black, which ties it in nicely with the coat. And I love that where it sits on me across body, it almost makes it look like it's an actual like belt bag, if that makes sense. It kind of makes it look like it's attached at the waist and not cross body. And I really love that. I think the two tones work really beautifully together because this is a warmer gray. It works really nicely with this bag, which I'm very grateful for because this is literally like my most used bag of 2020. All of my stuff is always in it. And I very rarely change bags at the moment. It's so practical, it holds up in the rain, it fits all of my like essentials like keys, wallet, mask, hand sanitizer, phone, vlogging camera, like fits everything I need in it. So yeah, this is my very chic but practical look in full.
So that is going to be it for me today. I really hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Let me know what your favorites were and what you think I should return in the comments below.
If you're new and you enjoyed this video, please do subscribe. I do a lot of fashion content that I think you will love if you like this video. But yeah, that is it from me. I hope you're all having the best day and I will see you guys again soon. Bye.